Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play. Another episode of Let's Play. Sorry about that. I kind of started that one. Star Wars: The Force Unleashed, PS2 edition. Last time we went through Braxis Prime and actually did not fight Proxy. That is something that is missing from this version. One of the few things it is. Surprisingly. In this episode, we're heading onto Bespin.
Master, I am pleased to see you are not dead.
We're heading into Cloud City Bespin. Go to the Cloud City and Bespin and meet the Senator Garmbale Iblis. Because yes, Garmbale Iblis had like no mention in that game. He kind of just appeared. We already knew Mon Mothma is. We kind of got an introduction to Bail Organa, but we never really got a mention of Bail Iblis. He's very low mentioned, except in like books and comics. But he is one of the founding members of the Rebellion and basically manages the entire fleet. And like, it's basically the general, the military. While Mon Mothma leads more of the administrative things and Bail led a little bit more of some other things, like about information. Garmbale Iblis was the main commander.
What do you want me to do?
Well, you'll need to get in touch with Lobot.
Who?
The city's chief administrator. If Garm is down there, he'll know where to find him.
And welcome to a full mission for Bespin. Not even a short one. It's a pretty long one too. I remember this. There's like four bosses here. Or something like that. I just realized the little headpiece there kind of reminds me of Vader, you know? Maybe the little, like, lip thing. Oh, what? Hey. Oi. I see you. Anyways, there's some regular dudes here. Could do that, but I'm not going to, so I'm gonna reload that save state. Just to showcase that you can do it, not that I'm going to, you know. Oh, things are going to crap in Cloud City, by the way. That's about a piece of the outside made it look.
I have a message from Master Ram Koda for the Senator.
The Senator is unavailable at the moment. The entire city has been overrun by criminals.
You will tell the Senator that I need to talk to him.
He is not available. The Senator is attempting to negotiate with one of the criminals, Chopa. He went to the loading bays to confront him.
Great. Come in, General.
Nice job. Try to force,
What do you know about Chopa?
You see him reacting. It's like, I have to think of that.
An immoral criminal who has taken over underworld operations in this sector.
So I can rule out diplomacy?
Well, that's a fair guess, boy. But if you deal with Chopa, you'll prove yourself to Garm. Head down to the loading bay and see what you can do.
Which way to the loading bay?
Oh, there are Mandalorians. Yeah, we have to deal with Mandalorians in this chapter. Pretty darn cool. Pirates, Mandalorians, and the like. There's a bunch of the exclusive enemies just here. Oh, guys with whip swords as well. Of Tals. Tals. I actually like the Tals race. They're cool. Again, more of the examples of there being a lot more enemy variety in this version compared to the regular console version. He's dead. Should be. Okay. The reason I'm doing that is because... Got it? No, you can't jump out these windows. Maybe you can. Nope. Outside one of these windows is a, outside a window, near here, is a light propellant. But let's just get this all around. Let's see, nope. Oh, use more EXP.
I found
him! Good job. I found him! Choked. Next snap. We are fighting Twi'lek enemies. Oh, brands! And they're the same text they do in the other games they're in. Chuck grenades! fan. Alright. Oh, hey! Now, if you're the crook, or one of the species. Very legends. No, they appear in canon. There's one of them, their most famous of their species is a Jedi Master. Ooh, fun fact, I actually lived, despite visibly dying in against General Grievous, didn't, and actually lived all the way to Luke Skywalker's Jedi Order. Also, thanks for helping here. He is scratching his head with a grenade! Get out! I thought I left you behind in the in dark forces. Get out! You know what? Ow! Freaking face! You know what? I have an idea. How about you? Get out the window! Also, here's to be a Tal's medic. Boop. And give me your health, please. Give me your health, give me your health, give me your health, give me your health, give me your health. Okay. Stop with the grenades! Also another Tal's, or no, it's a Uridorian. Or nope, he just phased the floor. I don't know what species he was, because he just phased right through a reality, so. So behind the elevator takes you to the one down the aisle. No more save right here, just in case. I definitely missed a couple things, probably. Yeah, I did. I missed a health holocron. It's fine. I mean, the game basically stopped giving health upgrades. Snap the Mandalorian's neck. I try to and miss and fail entirely. Impale him. I guess impalement works just as easily. I play more Star Wars games on this channel. That thing spawned out of reality, okay. I love Star Wars. I play Rogue Squadron one day because I own the series. I should play X-Wing. I should play the X-Wing series. So I played a little bit of it. I'm not that good. I'm really bad at it. But I can get good. Yeah, I don't know. Gotta love the I don't want to deal with you, let me push up a push maneuver. The elevator anyway, we go. Didn't mean to. Is that a Sith temple? Oh, there. Looks like a Sith temple in here, doesn't it? Ow, my face. Why are there three of you? Oh, okay. Force powers. Okay, nothing really I can increase that I want. Maybe detonator saber rolling. Ground slam, maybe. Maybe I should save. Why not? This could always increase damage. Maybe a little. Off! Off. Okay, that's an accident, but I'll take it. He's dead. You break your spine. Alien Chapa's thugs. Okay, force pushes always work pretty darn well, I'd say. I think I killed too many of them too quickly. Oh, I see. Okay. Good. We need to take out that thing. Let me try this. Boom. Nope. More of you. I actually don't know their name. Weirdly enough. You know, it's one of these Star Wars right, like, species that I don't know the names of. Okay. Shock close range. Okay, here. Okay, I'm getting destroyed. Ow, my face. Right, we are back. My cat's beyond the door. Ow. When in doubt, throw him a cliff. No. 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 I don't think this is supposed to happen.
The senator would very much like to see you.
I thought he might.
Meet him in the concourse as soon as possible.
I think you should take out this gram that's progressively exploding constantly on my body. Ow! He was waiting for that moment his entire life. Alright, be right back, guys. And I'm back. Alright, open sesame. How did he push me? Hopefully he fell off the cliff. Okay, he did. Heard his death noise. Alright. I say elevator open, it opens. And battling's the Mandalorians. I saw the HP bar coming. Pew 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 pew. I just realized they're using Jango Fett's blaster noise. That's cool. Again. This mission, like, honestly, in my opinion, what one of the reasons I personally really do think this version is the definitive version. Is because this mission alone is massive. I know I said that a lot with the Narcan mission, but I'm not kidding about this one. Use Force Lightning, though. Or Force Choke. Again. Force always wins. Usually. Force wins, unless you're the Old Republic villain. In that case, the Force will, in fact, fail you a lot. Alright, choking. Lightning. Set him on the floor. Joking. Use your body as a meat shield for good to this guy's bullets. Oh, hey, they're using the battle against Jango Fett's theme. That's a cool thing. Anyways. Wow, you're tanky. You gonna die? There you are. You really can resist having your neck snapped. For like a couple hours. Jeez. I know it's a really brutal thing to say again, but. Hey. Nice speech. But then they speak very brutally. I've noticed. If you've been watching this one, you probably know this. How about 1 year? Woo! 1 anniversary, let's plays, baby! And 100 subs! Looks like this thing actually managed to get. This playthrough actually managed to do it for that. Also, thank you for all the genuine, the positive, interaction. Because at this point in time, the Felucia Let's Play has 3 likes, which is, I think, the most likes I've ever had in a video. So, and I'm talking about the Felucia in the HD version. Like, thank you. Genuinely. Out of the way. The last blue lights were just here. I'm gonna say that. So, quick save. Boop. I don't really use quick save for this game, mostly because I don't need to. Lots, but okay. Alright. What are you guys doing? Oh, hello there. That ain't good. Gotta help. Well, more like avenge. Sadly. Considering the. Okay, there's 2 of them left. At least you managed to save 2 of 3 of them. 3 of them. Hearing a 3rd one spawned out of thin air. Get off! Oopsie! I say oopsie doopsie. I didn't mean to kill him. I swear. I didn't mean to throw an entire person at that guy. I solemnly swear I didn't mean to hurt him. Any more Mandalorians. I solemnly swear to not kill anyone. You didn't see anything, viewers. You didn't see anything. Oops. I'm pretty sure I just killed them all. Hooray! Starkiller's here to save us! Oh no! Starkiller's here to save us! Basically anyone Starkiller tries to stuff. Hooray! We saved Bespin! We did it! We did it, Coda! We saved Bespin! Just fry him. Fry him like the bug he is. Toast him. Really toasty. Okay, you're dead. You're dead. Well, actually, not dead. There you are now, dead. Oh, frick. Still applies.
Where's Garm? Chopper has sent bounty hunters. Senator Bell Iblis has been captured by one of them. A mercenary named Cleef.
Ah, crap.
Coda, the senator's been captured. I'm going after him.
Not again. There's a second senator of this game. Oops. By the way, there's no repercussions for defeat for taking out the people of Cloud City. Weirdly enough. No dark side, because there's no dark side points, there's no morality system other than the final choice. Which again, I will be showcasing both choices, because I can. Oh yeah, that's probably why they're screaming. You're not moving away. Okay, I think this area is the one with the lightsaber crystal. Yep. There's the final blue crystal. Only one more in the game. Which is the deep blue. Ooh! Obi-Wan blue! Nice! Okay. Other side has a, or never mind. Inside the elevator on the left is a Force holocron. But yeah. Anyways. What you doing there? Hey, villain Gungan!
An important Imperial senator.
An evil Gungan.
Yes, I got the senator, but Boss Chapa has him now. Not so funny. Sir, prepare.
Remember, Gungans, you shouldn't judge the Gungans by Jar Jar. Jar Jar is just kind of incompetent. The Gungans themselves are a warrior race. A warrior race which are very strong. So, yeah. I think it's the first one that actually kind of left his kid in the boat and attacked, like, pursue life piracy. I mean, heck, one became a very strong Jedi and Sith, respectively. So, don't mess with the gunk. Don't mess with Asa! Anyways, oh crap, I'm gonna hit the missile. Don't mess with Misa! Alright, just... Can you destroy these things? I'm trying to wonder. That's why I'm trying to destroy them right away. So they could just kill Cleef right now. Okay, you can. That's good. That does not have. Okay, more being grabbed. By the Force. Apparently. I don't think that was supposed to happen. Okay, he's actually using the electromagnetic balls. The Plasma Naboo. That's cool. That's really cool, actually. And he's using the weapons of the Gungans, too. He's multiple phases? Nope. I think he's almost dead, guys. As cool as he is, and honestly a really cool boss that should have been the main game. A cool character. Same with Dravik. With the Rodian smuggler leader. But he's dead. Oh, your sword's gone. Good luck then. Have fun falling forever. Oh, oof, ow.
Weren't prepared for that, were you?
Yeah, we're.
Brian, no, he was not. For launch. I'm going to find Chopa and the senator.
Yeah, the little lip piece on his chin, I just realized, is very similar to Vader's helmet. Exit. Same with the back part. I just realized this is Vader's suit. Wait a minute. How did I just realize this? This is Vader's suit! With the same, like, chest piece and everything! Like, this main body piece is Vader's. Yeah. Okay, I'm getting destroyed. I probably should focus on the battle, because I'm getting shot up by the Mandalorians. Oh, one of my toys. Ah, oh, God! Good job, you blew up your own teammate. Eat your own grenades! Get out there! Go back to the Dark Forces series! You're annoying there, and you're annoying now! Snap. Battle Bop? No. Okay. There we are. Use the lightsaber. Power of lights. I'm pretty sure that you ran off the cliff or something. Or just they just randomly died. Take him now! Get slammed to a wall! Get slammed to a wall! Ah! Okay, get out, you stupid enemies! Ah! Okay, fire that didn't explode. Hey, I killed him. Actually, managed to get him. I killed that guy. Okay, no, it didn't kill him. That didn't kill me either, but... Okay. Fire! Oops, I just killed a ton of our teammates. Those villains just died. Off. Nice. Force powers. Let's upgrade. Let's upgrade. Choke. Oh, I just realized the Maelstrom ability gives you a shield. That's what it upgrades. Zap, 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 zap. Thanks. 1000 HP. There's a lot of these guys. I was like, they're running the Gamorrean Guard enemies. I was like, oh yeah, because they're in this game. Okay, I have an idea. Okay, you're just spawning for a while. Help me! Help! Okay, shock you all. Some fried. I actually don't know what our species is supposed to be based off of. Boar? Boar. Okay, look at that. Alright. Slam. Welcome to the slam, and welcome to the jam. Hey, corridor where Luke Skywalker and Vader fought, and that's neat.
Let him go.
The Jedi.
Hello there.
I was hoping you'd come. Your talks have failed, Senator. This is how I negotiate.
This is totally gonna go well for you. Meets the man of another Mandalorian's battle. Because that guy we're fighting is a Mandalorian clan leader. Yep. Hey, they actually HP bar. Okay, so much damage you're doing to him. Okay, that actually is hitting. Oh no. Heck, wait a minute. Not wrong area. That should help. This should help! Ow, my face. Okay, Chapa. Just gonna fry him to death. And down he goes. Same tactics. Uh-oh. Hey, look. It's a Basilisk War Droid. Remember how they mentioned them before in KOTOR? We never saw them. Yeah, here's one in person. Yeah, we actually have to fight one in this game. Pretty darn cool! This is how you do a KOTOR reference. I think you're still around, considering they were outlawed. But... but hey. So is Star Wars. Ah! Even block them all. Okay. Can't reflect them, but oh my lord, that's a lot of bullets. Okay, I need to use the lightsaber. Ah! Oh! Okay, where's the health pickup? There's one. Mine. Now I can see why the Mandalorians rode these things in a battle. The pioneers that ride these babies for miles! Ah! Ah! I missed. Oof. Oh, frick. Hey, I wonder if I can force choke you. Probably not. Maybe like Thanksgiving's next week. Sorry, out of nowhere, I know, but like, it just occurred to me, Thanksgiving is next week. And I feel like no one is celebrating the probably are people celebrating, it's just the fact of, like, doesn't feel like it, you know? Doesn't feel like it's happened. I think soon. Yeah, I felt that one coming from a mile away. Okay, you're stunned. Okay. Woo! Where's cat? Where's nope. Customized lightsaber? Yes. Get my lightsaber water. Okay. Nice. They found the. Like, in this game, I think has way better QTEs. I think it says. Ultra dynamic. Ow. Yeah, Vassal's war droids and just devastated. And our boss isn't over yet, or maybe it is. Nope, no, it is not. Choppa is heading towards us in a staff versus lightsaber duel. And Choppa is a character who is, like, not a Jedi, so he is weak to the Force. Very much so. Boom! All objects being thrown at them in full force. This one? Nope. Nope, wrong object. No, no! I don't want him, I want the objects in front of him! Okay, he just ate that. Okay. Oh, force choke works. That's good to know. Okay, good to know, you can force choke him out of that block stance. Give me an honorable duel! Okay, chucks boxes.
The Senator! This is what they said to save you!
I am destroying this Mandalorian's sense of honor. Ow. Okay, he's almost defeated. There he is. It was exactly how I defeated him. That's cool. Bye-bye, Choppa. Defeated.
You're safe, Fall. Senator.
That was Ryu's line. I sure realized that.
Thank you, my friend.
I come on behalf of
General Coda. I know. And I know about your plans for rebellion.
Are you with us?
Is that Master Chief?
I've spoken out against the Emperor too many times. He's issued death warrants against me and my family. Of course I'm with you. We'll need to meet with Bail and the others.
Christopher
Tabori. Next move.
Thus Darth Desolus. Oh no, end. In Garm Bail Iblis. Christopher Tabori.
Tell Coda. I'll contact him soon.
Juno, I'm heading back.
See you soon.
Oh, he's a pretty famous actor. So, let's see. What did he voice act in? Apparently played in KOTOR, apparently. Oh, he's HK-47! Neat!
Your actions on Raxus Prime have left the Emperor most displeased.
The Emperor's enemies are still scared. I am just now earning
this
their trust.
This was Vulture and Well with Shadows.
If I'm ever discovered talking to you, if they even suspect my past, all that will be destroyed.
Do not wait too long to contact me.
They're already at Corellia. Bail and his allies.
You have your Rebel Alliance. Now what are you going to do with it?
Just trust me. Okay? I'm doing the right thing. For both of us.
Hey. And with the Bounty Hunter disguise costume. Yeah, we don't want the really cool one for the next mission, but hey. Let's see the new saber hilt, which is what appears to be Obi-Wan's lightsaber. Because Luke Skywalker's is... Isn't this Luke's? No, it's Obi-Wan's. Luke we'll has a little more black. Let's switch to that that Bounty Hunter costume. Still in the game, just way later. Okay, what do we get have for abilities that I want to get? Could save it for choke, but I kind of want to do another ability. Maelstrom is the shield. So. I might increase saber throw. Or. Repulse. But anyways, we have some bios to read. I was looking at the holocron viewer real quick. To showcase how many of the concept arts I got. Ooh, we even have the concept arts for the health and, or the renders, the health and, well, force holocrons. You're new. This is Rogue Shadow. There's Proxy. There's some renders of the Death Star. Yeah, it's a Death Star. Ooh, that's a cool one. That's the clouds, the... Yeah. There's the towels. Renders, along with the... Oh, let's hit you. Oh, I just realized. His Vibra Sword is Nabooian origin. It's like the architecture of it. Like, it comes... It's like from Otagunga design. Pretty cool. Anyways, let's look at the data bank. We already read Cloud City, so we have ourselves... The Basilisk War Droid first. Choppa's Notomo's mechanical mount, the Basilisk War Droid, is armed with a 3 powerful repeating blasters and low atmosphere repulsor lifts that allow it to hover in combat. Notomo's War Droid is based on an ancient Mandalorian machine of the same name. The droid possesses a rudimentary battle droid brain and can operate in nearly any environment, including the vacuum of space. Choppa Notomo. One of the last surviving Mandalorians, Choppa Notomo became a mercenary during the Clone Wars, fighting along the Separatists. He was disgusted by the Clone Troopers, who he viewed as abominable corruption of the Mandalorian's legacy. After the war, Choppa worked his way through the ranks of the criminal organization Black Sun before striking out on his own, eventually proving himself to be a cutting leader. Choppa took control of several underworld operations throughout the Bespin system, including those deep in the bowels of Cloud City. Despite missing one eye, Notomo is a vicious and capable combatant who wields a deadly prolonged electro staff. Yeah, I'm in Drexel. Anyways, HTFU, you're new. The Heavy Tactical Fighting Unit, or HTFU, was primarily developed by Delbin Servo Droid for the security force across the galaxy. Why does Delbin Servo Droid remind me of a Fallout name? You know, think about it. Servo Droid. Like, Mr. Handy's, the Assault Trons, Servo Droid. The Bespin Mining Guild has purchased and modified a number of these formidable droids to help patrol the guard their interests in the system. The HTFU is built to withstand a wide range of harsh planetary conditions, and its armored hull can resist massive impact attacks, heavy attacks, and other trauma that would destroy lesser droids. Though typically armed with only a powerful claw arm capable of detaining thieves and other undesirables, Bespin miners have modified the local HTFU units to include a retractable fire blade and deadly cutting laser. Why? Cleef. An Otla Gungan and veteran of the Battle of Naboo. Huh, cool. Cleef is a bounty hunter and member of Choppa Motomo's mercenary band in God City. Considered Motomo's second in command and most trusted lieutenant, Cleef is also greatly feared for his combat skills. Cleef's career began shortly after the Battle of Naboo when he left his homeworld as part of Senator Jar Jar Binks' security detail. Bored by his job and seeking both an adventure and credits, Cleef abandoned Binks and delved into the course on Underworld. A master of many weapons, Cleef put his skills to a good use as a bounty hunter, working for the highest bidder during the Clone Wars. He eventually crossed paths with Notomo, who hired him and trained Notomo's other recruits. Priding himself on the depths of his preparation, Cleef hunts his prey relentlessly and ensures that he always has the right equipment to finish any job. Wasn't prepared for me, though. As Mr. Mr. Starkiller has mentioned. Lobot. Cloud City's computer liaison officer. Lobot has been fitted with a cybernetic skull implant wrapped around his skull, which will increase his intelligence, allows him to directly communicate with most of the computers, including Cloud City's central computer core. All considered the real mastermind behind Cloud City, Lobot's life did not always hold the promise of a bright future. He was born the son of a slaver and an apprentice in that vile profession early in life. However, when Lobot was only 15, his father was killed by pirates during a raid in the Outer Rim system. The murderers took Lobot captive and forced him into a grueling life of slavery, much as he and his father had done so to many others. After serving his pirate masters for 2 years, Lobot managed to escape and fled to Cloud City. Fortunately, he found himself alone, impoverished, and on the verge of starvation. In order to survive, Lobot became a thief, but the lifestyle did not suit him well, and he was soon captured. Though convicted of his crimes, Lobot abstracted the attention of Cloud City's Baroness Administrator Elisa Chalence. For quite some time, the Baroness had been controlled by the Cloud City's complex computer core, which controlled all the floating city's functions but needed constant maintenance, upgrades, and repairs. In Lobot, Chalence saw a solution to her dilemma. The Baroness approached Lobot with an enticing offer. Rather than spend the rest of the next several decades in prison, as had been his sentence, Lobot could repay his debt for becoming Cloud City's first computer liaison officer. Lobot readily accepted, although he understood that he would be enslaved to Cloud City for quite some time. To serve his new post, Lobot needed a method for communicating with Cloud City's central computer core. Thus, he was fitted with numerous cybernetic enhancements, including a computer bracket implanted in the back of his head. The modification gradually increased Lobot's intelligence and gave him full access to the central computer core, allowing him to control Cloud City's computers, security devices, comm systems, propulsion lifts, gas mining equipment, and life support systems. In exchange for his vast powers, the cybernetic enhancements damaged his speech centers, limiting to only brief and infrequent sentences. Lobot has now served Cloud City faithfully for over a decade, and will continue to serve it well into the fall of the Empire and beyond. Heck, if you've ever played Jedi Outcast, you know he's even serving till then, when Luke's Academy is fully set up and the New Republic rules, like, is basically controlling a lot of things, and it's just the Imperial Remnant left. Princess Leia is already red, Bull Rancor is red, Felucian Warriors, Heavy Jump Troopers, Heavy Medic, da-da-da-da. Junk, Rowdians, Scrap Scavengers, Wookiee, no pirates? No pirates or anything? Okay. Just one last look to see if I missed anything. No! I didn't miss anything. Alright. Alright, so next on Let's Play Star Wars The Force Unleashed PSP, we're going to be heading into the final mission of the game. The Death Star. Along with also, and then the next step after that, we'll be showcasing the, some of the cheat codes, and, well, after that, we'll move on to the DS, which will probably be actually not streamed, sadly. I'll be doing it in person again. So, see you guys then. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Peace.